This video, we will review the Infor Document Management Context application. In-context applications are used during navigation through Infor applications that provide the users views into additional information. The Infor Document Management In-Context widget is called Related Information. This widget retrieves information from IDM showing the documents that are related to the record or business object that is selected. If a different business object is selected, the IDM context widget updates the visible related information. You can also view related documents, which can be configured at the document type level. This depends on the correct configuration of the IDM in context app. You can turn the app on or off in the Mingle administration settings. The Related Information in context app lets you easily attach relevant documents by browsing your folders or dragging and dropping the file directly into the app. This is a convenient way to link an order slip or an agreement to a purchase order, documentation specific to an item record, or an asset repair guide to an asset. Those documents then belong to a document type which link the record through the record's key fields. When you add a document type, you identify the business entity or the context and the document type. Once the document is linked, you'll be able to access the document when the record is selected. In this image, I'm accessing the item record in a list, a composite form, and from the item dashboard. In all three examples, the context is the same as an item from the item master, as well as the key information, which in this case is the item group and the item number. Now let's take a look at how it works. Using our item example, when I am on the item dashboard, a context message is sent through Mingle and is routed to the appropriate context applications like IDM. Here we can see the entity type is Infor Item Master in the key fields including item group and item number. IDM maps the context message to the documents through the business context model. The key information section includes the entity, product, screen, and document type. The X query identifies the key information to link the document to that record. Here we can see the ID1 and ID2 identified. These correspond to the item group and item number mentioned earlier. And finally, the In Context widget will display the documents based on the context message and the mapped results. Now let's walk through a brief demo. For this example, we'll attach a document to a purchase order. But first, let's take a look at the settings within IDM. To do this within the IDM application, you can access the Control Center. And first, let's take a look at the document type. Since we're working with a purchase order, let's take a look at the purchase order document type. Under the general settings, I can see the display name and the document type, but I can also take a look at the business context attributes. Here you can configure which attributes and properties will be available to the published business context message for the document type, and you can view these messages in the context viewer. The attributes tab identifies the attributes associated with this purchase order document type. The access control list provides a list of roles and responsibilities for this document type. One can be set as the default, but this can be changed when a document is added. Now let's take a look at the business context modeler. This can be found under the configuration menu option. Within the business context model, look for the entity of Infor purchase order, and for the screen, purchase order entry, since that's the screen we'll be entering the document on. Let's go into the edit screen and take a look at the key values. Here we can see the key information, including the entity and for purchase order, the product of FSM, the screen name we've identified as purchase order entry, and the document type of purchase order. The X query shows the key information that's going to link the document to the screen and context. In this case, the key fields is the company represented by the ID1 and the purchase order number represented by the ID2. Now let's go into the application and attach a document to a purchase order. So I've created a purchase order, I've added my lines, but let's say I wanted to add a quote, such as this one, to the purchase order for reference. Let's access the context apps through the double arrows at the top right of the screen. And from here I can see my context viewer, and I can see my related information app. First, let's take a quick look at the context viewer and see where this information comes into context. Looking at the Context Viewer app, I can see where it identifies the screen I'm on. In this case, it's a purchase order entry screen. Scrolling down a little further, I can see the other information that was identified in the Business Context Modeler, including the entity type, ID1, in ID2. And this is the information that's getting sent to IDM that's going to link the document to a purchase order. Moving on to the Related Information app, or the IDM Contextual app, there's a couple different ways I can attach documents. First, I could click on the paperclip and browse my files if I want to do it that way. But in this case, I have the document attached to my desktop, so I can just drag and drop that directly into the application itself. The name defaults from the file name, and if I go down to the additional details, I can see where it auto-populates the company and the purchase order number from the contextual information. Scrolling down, I can see my attributes are not filled in, but that's okay because this purchase order has not been released yet. And at the bottom, I can update the access control list if I want to change it from what it defaults from. Once I've verified the information, I can click Upload, and that'll send the document over to IDM. Before we release the purchase order, let's take a look at this document in IDM. Here I can see the document came over as expected. Clicking on the attributes, I can see the only attributes showing are the purchase order and company as we stated before. Now let's go back and release the purchase order. Once the purchase order is released, it'll send the rest of the attributes over to the document in IDM. So let's go back into IDM and take another look at the attributes, where we'll see all the rest of the attributes that are filled in as expected. And finally, returning back to the application, there are a few other actions I can take right from the contextual app. By clicking on the ellipsis, I have options where I can share the document, I can download it, save as a PDF, or even email it to somebody directly from Infor Document Management. Thank you for watching, and please continue to visit for additional information and future videos.